BBC and we coming at you full force. With nut buzz, fuck ducks and some dull swords. Cuss words, buzz kills, getting caught quick. We the thing to make your brain break, the shit to make your nuts itch. So sit down and get back, better ready up your head for a full blown attack. In fact, we the best kind of poison. So come and join us, the Beautiful Boys Cast.
Fucking bored. I
can. And we're back.
Oh, we're fucking back,
we're
dude.
Bad. We're arguing about my. I gotta take a poopy. I'm gonna
He's gonna take a poopy.
He's gotta take a poopy.
I'm gonna complain about this Amazon Playboy sign.
Yeah,
for about
dude.
15 minutes.
Wait, we just started the pod.
Cool that we just bought?
What?
This episode is sponsored by Camel.
Yeah. How do you switch to it? Show them our new sign.
Yeah. Show them our.
With our lack of Playboy sign, we got a new sign.
Introducing.
The Camel cigarette
the
sign.
The Camel cigarette sign.
Dude, what the fuck? Why is it not coming up?
Introducing.
Josh not knowing how to do this.
The Camel cigarette.
Just push the camera towards it for a sec.
Would you take a picture?
Dude, just take a picture of it and then,
and
show,
then show the camera.
Show
and
with the camera.
It, and then hopefully that actually like displays.
Get it real. Hold on. But enhance.
Enhance?
All right, just look up old vintage light-up Camel sign.
Oh, there you go.
There we go, because that's what we got.
That's what we got.
It usually, that's where the guests would be. We don't have a guest today, so.
So, all five Camels are our guests.
Yeah, but our fucking sign isn't working for our goddamn symbol.
Our classic Playboy sign.
Like, what the fuck, dude? What the fuck, Amazon? You're lucky we got that 2-year warranty.
We got that fucking warranty. We got that product guarantee.
But this is fucking up the whole vibe.
Hopefully, the issue is just a cord, and then we can replace the cord, and then we can have two.
Yeah.
Playboy.
I'm going to lie to him and tell him that it fucking it sucks.
Shit,
it's fully broken. I need another one.
Right now. God damn it.
I'm going to hang that bitch by my bed.
Yep. That's where it should be.
Mm-hmm.
It's like a mantelpiece.
It's like, I wonder if now they can read the hustle, or if the hustle is still too bright that it just looks like
I
a
think
pink
the hustle,
light.
It just looks like a big, like
the sun, like a little star.
Yeah. I might end up just taking that down and putting it somewhere else to use as like light on us. Because no one can read, it says hustle.
It says hustle.
Stay hustling.
Stay hustling.
Maybe you
stay
can
bustling.
Move the size does matter sign there.
Mm.
And they would probably be able to read that because it's less.
The problem right. with the size does matter sign is that you got to keep on taking it off the wall to turn it on and off because it's run by batteries in the back. Mm. Even though they should be in the bottom, if you're going to be a sign that needs batteries, they should be accessible.
That's a critical design flaw. And how long do the batteries last?
Right, not that long because you can't. I mean, there's a thing to turn it off on the back, but you got to take it off the wall.
So you wouldn't be able to use stickies, really?
No. I think it's held up there with stickies. We just don't use
you
the light of it.
You might be able to put it just on the dog poker.
Yeah. Maybe I'll make like a little, like, I'll take like two little L brackets and just put it under it as a little shelf.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe. Who knows?
Who fucking knows, man? These are just options.
This fucking vape sucks. I'm going to wait for him to get back and ask him for his chug jug.
Tutti Frutti?
Tropical Rainbow Blast.
Tutti Frutti Delight?
Dude, my store got fake elf bars.
That's sick.
It rules, dude. I came in and I was like, oh shit, we got elf bars. Maybe I'll grab one. And I looked at it and I was like, that says elf bar nowhere on it.
Oh,
it
said an
it
elf
just
bar?
Said, it just, instead of elf bar, it had the big BC 5000 thing, and then I had like a little bowl of fruit at the top.
Oh,
like
really?
A little image of a bowl of fruit.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And I like had to tell my work, like, yo, you guys know you bought fake elf bars, right? And they're all like, what?
Yeah.
And I was like, you can't sell these to people like online unless you put that they're not real. We're going to get sued.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We got those in them Lost Marys, which those are gay. It looks like a crushed juice box.
A crushed juice box?
Yeah, a lot. You ever seen those? They look like elf bars, but they're like all like crushy looking. Like it looks like someone squeezed it too hard.
No.
Pull up a Lost Mary. After you're done tying your shoes.
Yeah, bro.
That obviously need to be tied in case you start walking.
Dude, what if an asteroid comes?
Make sure you click on the... Did you click on that first before you touched anything on the keyboard?
Yes.
We're still recording, correct?
We're still recording it.
Hell yeah.
It only says stop. Okay,
fucking so hell yeah.
Lost Mary?
Yeah, Lost Mary. It looks all crushed up. Looks like a crushed boy. Yeah, did you want images?
Oh.
Doesn't that look a little crushed?
Oh, it's like grippies.
Yeah, it's like fucking squeezed.
It's got grippies.
It's got some squeeze to it.
That's interesting.
I was thinking about getting one of them because it said watermelon, but then you can't trust it.
Mm-hmm.
I need to hit someone else's watermelon one first before I know. What are you going to put on?
I'm thinking. It's probably just going to be Fortnite, but...
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hell yeah, dude.
Hey.
Hey, no fucking volume. Get out of here. Shut up. Dude, I finished playing It Takes Two this week. You ever play that? It's a strictly two-player game.
I've heard of it. Seems like a good time.
Yeah, because, I mean, me and Cassidy go out of our way to, like, find games that are multiplayer because they just don't make a lot of those anymore. It's all online multiplayer.
Yes.
And that shit's stupid. Whatever happened to The Hang? You know what I mean?
Split screen, you know what I mean?
The liberal left wants you...
The liberal left wants to take away split screen.
They
want to
take away split screen Halo, dude.
They don't want you to play as the Arbiter and the Master Chief.
They don't want you to play Call of Duty Zombies with your boys.
They don't want you to play four-man zombies.
What is going on?
On threes and COD World at War. What is going on?
They don't want your buddy to grab your controller forcefully out of your hands as soon as they're down and go revive themselves. They don't want that.
They want you to spend all of your points to open all the doors for your friend so they can pack a punch before you.
It's like they don't want you to play with, like, fucking Mortal Kombat with your buddy and then unplug his controller before the game starts and then you wail on his silly ass.
They don't want you to go like this at his controller while he's hitting a sick combo on you to mess him up.
It's like, seriously, like, you can't even smack your buddy's nuts super hard while they're trying to mess you up in injustice.
Dick flick him real quick.
It's fucking messed up, dude.
It's a fucked up world.
And I don't appreciate it. And I know that for sure.
Yeah. I know that much. That's not the America I grew up in.
I just want to play Fortnite with the boys at the house. What's so wrong with that?
Why can't I play four-man Fortnite?
Yeah, why can't I get four tiny split screens for all my boys?
That's all they sell nowadays.
Yeah, for real, dude.
That's all they fucking sell nowadays is big-ass TVs.
You can't even go four-way split screen on a 20-inch TV no more. What the fuck?
They sell fucking, like, 70-inch TVs and you can't...
Trying to have a mid-ass time with the boys, dude. What the hell?
They don't understand the pain.
Dude, I remember before I fucking was diagnosed with glasses.
You can't see too good.
And, dude, four-player Mario Kart, dude, I looked like a fool. I looked like I'd never get my license, ever.
This is fucking up bad.
I can't believe you boys came against me in saying that you shouldn't use a Wii remote for Mario Kart. I mean,
dude,
on.
Fuck you, bro. Use a GameCube controller if you have the option.
It's more fun with a wheel.
Nah, fuck that.
Your fucking girl over there believes
it. Sometimes you can disagree on things, and I disagree on the fact that GameCube controllers are the superior use of Mario Kart. Yeah, whatever.
They're not. Need that.
I'm gonna keep living my life stick, how bro. It is, because it's been treating me pretty nice.
You ain't ever know the subtle touch of a nunchuck. Of a Wii nunchuck.
I'll tell you what, though. For some reason, I had, like, a Wii bat.
Yeah. Everybody had those.
I had a Wii
bat. The tennis racket.
I had a Wii gun.
The golf club.
I had a Wii gun.
There was
a hunting game.
Dude, you know they made a bowling ball?
No shit.
Dude, you know how scary that is? You're playing Wii bowling and you have the ball? I'm throwing that bitch at the TV.
Is there a wrist?
They better have a... Yeah, if they had to have had a wrist strap on.
Yeah.
Also... If you use one of those wrist straps, you're probably, like, you know, like, abiding by society right now. You probably work in an office job.
If you wore the Nintendo wrist strap, you are a sheeple.
Yeah, you're not a CEO, dude. The CEOs never wore the wrist strap. Real motherfuckers don't have enough time for that.
Real motherfuckers throw the Wii remote through the TV.
Real motherfuckers are too autistic and don't like the feeling of that weird
Wii strap shit
on your wrist, dude. He's really laying down a piper up there, huh? You know what I mean? He's running.
He's really letting out chocolate monkey.
He's slamming down a fat stinky.
Yeah. Yup.
A fat stinky, dude, for sure.
He's using a dude wipe.
I think he claims to use dude wipes, but doesn't actually, because he doesn't. No one really likes it.
No, like, I have the Manscaped version of dude wipes.
Oh, the man wipes or whatever they come. Yeah.
I haven't used them yet. I'm gonna bring them camping.
I thought that was for. Imagine if it was like little alcohol wipes for rubbing your dick down before you shave. Or after.
After.
Like, you know, when they...
Dick aftershave?
When they line you up and then they spray the alcohol on your forehead?
Yes.
Yeah, dude. Just do that right on your, like...
They do have
the... Your scarred penis.
They have crop preserver. They have, like, fucking, like, ball deodorant.
Yeah, the ball deodorant's nice.
I have it. I own it.
I don't know, dude. I've asked so many times on so many occasions from so many people for a Manscaped, but I've never had one. I'm about to get the Philips one.
Dude, I got the Plow 4.0, bro. It's decent.
I don't know, dude. I'm just at the point where it's fucking...
It was a gift. I didn't buy it. I bought one, then I lost it, then I got one as a gift.
Dude, I'm just too manly for that pussy shit, dude. I'll cut my dick all day long, dude. That's what I'm talking about.
That's not without saying I don't nick myself.
They act like you don't.
If you're not using the guard, you can still nick yourself no matter what. Loose skin is loose skin, man.
Who's using a guard on their nutsack, man? There needs to be a better way.
There's got to be a better way.
There's got to be a better way to shave your nutsack. There's no way fucking God put hair on this thing for me to hurt myself every time I shave it.
Stretch that shit out the best you can, but it's never good enough.
Fucking hitting the spine. Hitting the spine at the root, dude. It hurts. Why is there that extra little bit of skin that connects with... Why did God sew me on the underside of my cock?
Because that's where he had to do it.
Like, dude, I would have much preferred like a full-blown scar down everyone's back than the underside of my dick.
That's where it had to be sewed, man.
That's fucked up, man. I feel like it's got to be worse for chicks, though.
Oh, yeah?
You don't have a goatee. You gotta get real close to the hole.
Real close. That's true. Like,
it's like when skateboarders like grind on something really tall, but, you know, like it's like a 10-foot thing, but they're just like around the side and then they hop back in. Like, that shit was close, man.
Very close.
That thing slips, dude, and just falls in. You got a full-blown razor. Dude, I would never.
Not for me.
That's why they need to have professionals for these things.
They gotta have a ball trimmer.
There's gotta be a guy, dude, that just knows his way around a pair of nut sacks.
I bet that'd be a well-paying job.
It would, dude.
You get a lot of tips.
I'd tip, for sure. Yeah.
I'd tip like 50% probably.
You'd probably be like unattracted to everybody at that point then, because you see them at their worst, their hairiest.
Yeah.
It's like how, fucking Puerto Rican barbers. You ever seen those videos where it's just, like, a raggedy-ass, fucking hairy-ass Puerto Rican? Whoa! It's back!
It's back, baby!
It's back, baby! Dude, it chimed in. It was like, yeah, dude, I watch Puerto Rican hair TikTok all the time. Yeah, and there's some fucking raggedy-ass bum Puerto Rican-looking dude comes in there and gets lined the fuck up.
Mm-hmm.
Looks like a whole different person. Oh, man, he didn't agree. He thinks that they look gross either way.
Yeah, because he's mean. Like,
racist-ass Playboy
racist
sign.
Ass, what do you expect out of a Hugh Hefner sign?
Man? For real, dude. Do you think Hugh Hefner didn't fucking, you know...
Have some core values?
Yeah. Who was the first black guy ever allowed in the Playboy mansion? We get that?
Jarvis?
Jamie, pull up the first black guy at Hugh Hefner's place. Why do I feel like it's going to be like Richard Pryor? Someone like, or like Eddie Murphy. First black person Playboy. In the Playboy mansion.
Yeah.
It might just be a Playboy model.
Yeah. I don't think there's going to be anything.
There was never a black person in the Playboy Mansion.
That's the answer we have.
That's horrendous, man.
That's fucking deplorable.
If I were Hugh Hefner, dude,
I'd be very inclusive.
I would have all the small dick black dudes there. Yeah. Nothing else. What, you think I'm going to let some fucking... Even white dudes, dude, I'm dong checking at the door. You gotta be smaller than me to come in this bitch.
Dong check.
I'm doing a good dong check. And I'm doing it personally. I can't trust these snakes that work for me. You know?
Yeah.
Just letting all these big dick savages in.
Mm-hmm. What if they're like real growers,
bro? John Cena. Oh no, John Cena died.
What if they're like real growers, bro, and you don't realize at the door? But then, they like slip through the cracks.
I'm gonna make them get hard at the door.
Yep.
I'll personally jerk them off first. Yep.
You gotta test the waters, man.
I'm sitting at the door with a centerfold
mm-hmm.
of like a Playboy issue. Like, look at this for a little bit.
Stare this shit, man.
I'm staring at his cock.
Yep.
There's like one of those you must be this tall to ride like signs, but it's like
no horizontally. You put the dick on the table and as it grows yeah. further on the graph
where it says like yes up to like 4 inches and then no.
Yep. Get out of here.
Get the fuck out of here, you big dicked weirdo.
This shit ain't normal. You're man
trying to fuck my beautiful girls with your weird big dick. Get the fuck out of here. That would rule, man.
Yep.
How did he get that job? Did he just know a bunch of whores that wanted to get their pictures taken? Was that how that works? And then he was like, look what's about to happen. I'm going to put them in a magazine and everybody's going to come to it. And then I'm going to be a millionaire. Was Playboy the first, like, porn mag? He was aware. Oh, I can't read.
He was aware there was a market for a men's magazine and scraped together $8,000 from family and friends to publish the first issue of Playboy with Marilyn Monroe on the cover in December
1953. Full nude?
Probably, man. I mean, it's a Playboy.
Can we get Marilyn Monroe's titties off my hand? Sure. Also, move your mic a little closer to you.
It's hard.
I know. We need to get you a lap desk. I think I might have one. I'll bring it in. It's like a desk with like a beanbag on the bottom of it so you can put it on your lap. We can't get full tits?
I'm not sure.
I want to see nipple.
I want to see Marilyn Monroe full tits.
And we're looking for Marilyn Monroe full nipple.
There's that.
I don't even know what's going on. I want full tits. Oh, wait. I want full tits.
We were talking about who the first...
I come back and get.
Hell yeah.
Nice, bro.
We were talking about we were wondering who the first black guy to ever go in the Playboy Mansion was.
I couldn't really find an answer.
I know who.
And then
Jackie Robinson.
You think?
100%.
I was saying like probably like Richard Pryor or something.
No, Jackie Robinson. He was popping at the time, bro, when it first started coming out.
I don't know. We looked it up and they said that there's never been a black person there. So I don't know what you're talking about.
Ever in the
you can't step foot on this property.
I was saying if I was Hugh Hefner, I'd only allow small dick black guys there. And no one bigger than me is allowed. Well, Playboy sign turned on back for a second, and then it went away. How is your poopy?
You use a dude wipe?
Did I use a dude wipe?
Did you? It's a fucking...
It was like fucking like three.
It's an honest question, dude.
It's a pretty straightforward question, actually.
Yeah, Jimmy, obviously it's a fucking dude wipe. I took a shit. What do you think I'm doing? Do you think I'm shitting without a dude wipe?
I'm just checking.
We're accusing you of not actually using dude wipes.
I'm just checking you. Yeah.
You need to smell my asshole right now?
Uh-huh.
Let's do it.
Yo, can I hear your chug, dog?
Sure. Except you'd be too scared to sniff my asshole. You'd be like,
Whatever, dude. I was talking to Cass the other day, and I was like, need my ass? And she was like, no. And I was like, fucking Josh would.
No.
Yeah, I would eat your ass.
Dude, if we were gay, you'd be
eating
my ass.
I wouldn't get my ass
all day.
Eaten, though.
You'd let me try, for sure. Actually, I wouldn't want to do it, dude. It'd be perfect dynamic. If we were two gay guys, it'd be perfect, dude.
Yeah.
I wouldn't eat your ass. You don't want it to be ate.
Mm-hmm.
You'd eat my ass because you love it, and I'd probably enjoy.
Mm-hmm. And everyone wins.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. And we got that shmoney. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Fucking die from smoking mad ciggies at, like, 65. But all our money goes to, like, side swings.
Your tie swings?
Side swings. Side twinks. Not tie swings, side swings. Side tie swings.
Side tie swings.
What are you doing, dude?
He's hacking the mainframe.
The Matrix. Dude, can you believe this? Right now they got the sword in Fortnite. They got the Attack on Titan shit in Fortnite. And lightsabers, bro.
They got a lot going on.
Have we ever seen this many goated weapons before?
Ever seen this much fun and action-packed shit in Fortnite at the same time?
No, I don't think so. And I don't understand. You boys haven't been on. And you haven't fixed it.
No, I haven't taken the time.
Why isn't... I mean, I can't even... Why am I... I haven't been on in fucking months, man.
I gotta be real. I've only played like twice this week, but... I really need a grind, bro. I need that Darth Maul skin. Like, I really... Like, this month, like, we have to, like, May 20-something, bro. I need to grind.
I told Julia, I said, listen...
We're broken up for the month.
I'm gonna be seeing you a little
less. Some important shit in Fortnite.
Oh, we're broken up for the month. I gotta grind.
I hope you understand.
That's how, like, dude. That's why being gay would rule. Just tell your boy. It'd be a mutual discussion. Be like, nah, we're not seeing each other this month.
We're grinding.
We're grinding.
We can talk on Discord.
We'll play duos. I mean, fine. But I'm not eating any ass.
I was like, if I get a PlayStation, I was like, would you play with us? I was like, that way you don't gotta freak out and be like,
dude, don't you ever bring any girls into the fucking Fortnite lobby, bro.
Yeah, but we can use it to be like Jake.
You like hop in and you're like, hey guys, my girlfriend's here. That's like, boot.
Do the soccer ball.
Hey, what's the shape of Italy? Julia, what's the shape of Italy?
We're doing the soccer ball, Julia. You kick it.
I was like, it'd be like a VJ situation.
What?
It'd be like playing with VJ.
What? Oh, is she bad at Fortnite?
Probably.
You didn't check before you started dating her?
No.
Yeah.
I made Cassie play a few games.
You good at Fortnite?
What? You didn't check?
Jesus Christ.
Oh my God, dude.
That's a lot.
Good boys, you guys gotta make sure.
Dude, I'm the only one Tom Likas is fucking with right now. He knows.
Boys, you gotta make sure.
I've been playing with Tom all week on Fortnite. He's been ragging on you guys.
No shit.
Yeah, dude. He's like, where's Josh? Tom Likas 101, where's Josh? Is he out not fixing his server right now?
Not fixing his Wi-Fi?
What a bitch.
What a bitch.
You gotta make sure your woman knows how to play Fortnite and then boot her from the lobby.
8 times.
She carries your ass, but you're still gonna boot her because she's a woman.
Because it's fun.
Oh my fucking cunt. I'm gonna shoot
myself. Dude, what is going on?
What's the situation?
Forget your fucking shades.
Hey man, you need to cool it.
Dude, I'm about to boot you, dude, if you don't cool down, dude. It's the shape of Italy. Just bring a podcast guest on. What's the shape of Italy?
A boot?
Yeah, when was the last time you shit your pants? They're like, oh, I've never. And I'm like, what's the shape of Italy?
Bruno, get the fuck out.
Get the fuck out of here.
Get the fuck out of here, man. Well, you never shit your pants? Get the fuck out of here. Shit your pants right now. That's what you gotta do.
That's what you gotta do. That's what you gotta poo. Man. Dude, I've been doing gay King Von all week because it's really easy. Yeah.
King Von.
I just got some top from a stripper dude. He like a food. It's hard because there's a lot of good ones I have that involve the N word.
Whoa.
I just got some top from this gay sexin. Yes.
Gay sex fella.
Is it, you know what I've been doing too though? You can just replace it with plumber.
Plumber.
Yeah. I just got some top from my gay sex and plumber. I think I did a full one about you giving me head, if I don't recall.
That's cute.
Yeah. Because it was, I think it was the stick to the code.
Stick to the code.
Giving me top, I'm coming out his nose. You know what I mean?
The code.
Just stick to the code.
Got some plumbers locked up and they know what they know.
They only know what they know. Stick to the code.
Dude, I've been seeing a bunch of highlights all over the place on it, like Trump highlights and fucking shit like that.
He's back.
I'm thinking about making a montage of Zach Braxter highlights because I feel like motherfuckers don't remember how nasty I was as Zach Braxter.
Absolutely.
I got
clips.
I got clips of Zach Braxter kick flipping shit, taking crazy bong rips, screaming about fat women on the internet.
Yeah.
There's so many fucking Zach Braxter clips that are just not out there because they were supposed to be. We were going to start a Patreon eventually, and it was just Zach Braxter saying, like, terrible shit.
Yes.
So there's a video of, like, not me, because I'm not him.
You're not him?
I mean, how could I be, dude? Look at me, and then look at Zach Braxter.
Look how great Zach Braxter is.
I know I get it a lot, because they look a little similar in the face, but no.
Yeah, you got tattoos.
Yeah, obviously. I have tattoos, and Zach Braxter doesn't.
You copied Zach Braxter's tattoos.
Zach Braxter's, like, 33 years old.
Yeah.
I'm not like a fucking drug addict on the internet like him, dude. But, yeah, I was thinking about putting some clips together because I do appreciate his sport, you know? Mm-hmm. He was nasty.
He was at his time.
At his time.
Dude, remember that one where he's like, pew, 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 pew. Are they doing karate? Dude. Mm-hmm.
He's doing Naruto.
Remember that time he pissed his pants?
Yeah, dude, that was crazy. He was really loaded. No one's gonna know what we're talking about.
What's that chick called that they
Jitsus?
Do? Jitsus.
Bing, 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 bing.
You ever seen that black retarded kid online that does Naruto?
Yes. Yeah. Yeah.
This is awesome. Who, like, remember when he got the mohawk that was dyed like blonde, and he was like, "Now this is sick." Believe it.
Not that, but that's funny.
Look at black Naruto TikTok kid. This kid rules, man. They're really not gonna show him? Is that
Fortnite balls.
Gay sex Fortnite gay balls.
Little Mosey's white.
Dude, Little Mosey rules. I've been doing like deep research on Little Mosey all week. He is like an honor student at like one of the richest like high schools to go to in like all of like America.
You mean Lil Mabu?
Yeah, Lil Mabu, not Lil Mosey. Lil Mosey is white though. Yeah, I've been doing Lil Mabu research all week, dude. Yes, you got it. All right, now where's the? All right, restart it.
Now this is a match. I love it. Believe it.
All right, here we go. This is me every morning.
Rasengan! Now this is a match. I love it.
Good.
Believe it. Okay.
Yeah, that's a match, man. What's his name? Whatever, it doesn't matter. We don't have to give him clout. Just you know what we're talking about. The fucking little autistic black kid that thinks he's Naruto.
Yes, exactly.
Everybody knows what we're talking about.
Everyone knows.
I just got some top from a fucking dude. He from Kankachu.
He just bought a cock in my booty hit.
Cock. Instead of on.
Top. So I've had a theory, boys.
A theory.
I want to talk about it.
Talk about it.
I just want to let that Mac fly, just like not go. Gotta trust, bonus packs a nigga. He from Tennessee, I had a thought. She be with this shit, she told me wavy. I say for show, baby, let me know.
I say for show, do let me throw. You know how it go, I bust a nut, then I let it rope.
Yeah, that's for show.
That's for show. But yeah, what were you saying? Sorry, King Von. Yeah,
he took over.
It's pretty similar to King Von.
Oh, that's cool. It's spit.
I want to talk about how Big Time Rush is the greatest boy band in the history of all time.
Oh. You're forgetting about A Day to Remember.
No. Dude, listen. Who has more hits than Big Time Rush? I know more Big Time Rush hits than NSYNC hits, than Backstreet Boys hits, than...
I gotta say, though,
you know,
One Direction does go pretty hard.
One Direction does go pretty hard.
Kinda hard.
Big Time Rush also has more bangers than them. Also...
None of them have a show. That's true. Yeah. That's another
thing. Also, none of them have a show. Also, none of them have a feature with Snoop Dogg, and Snoop Dogg hopped into the music video when he didn't need to because they had a regular version of the song without him.
That's very true.
The music video with, but Snoop Dogg decided to hop in the music video with them.
That's true.
That sounds pretty hype. Of all
time. They are pretty cool, man. I always like the hockey. And the one that wore the hockey suit
that can go away for 7 years and come back bigger.
Come back just fine.
Actually, nah, the Wiggles, bro.
That's true.
The Wiggles were gone for like 15 plus years, and then they did like the biggest bar tour of all time.
But then they were fucked up for a little bit too. They had like that bitchin' band.
Yeah, man, dude. I mean, you can't always do fruit salad.
Yummy.
Like, not everyone can be a fruit salad yummy yummy banger. That's just how it goes.
Sometimes you write. Sometimes you hit.
Wait.
What about penis salad? Yummy, yummy. You know what I mean, dude?
Could be that.
What about, yeah, dude.
Right.
What about the wiggle your dicks?
I got it. I tossed a salad.
Yummy. I tossed this fruit salad. It was yummy, yummy. Yeah.
That's it.
What happened to the fruit of the womb, motherfuckers?
Yeah, the guys wearing like the fruit.
The fruit. If I don't recall, wasn't there a commercial where they fought?
Yeah.
I remember the fruit of the womb, motherfuckers, throwing hands. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah, I did too.
I feel like I really remember like though there was that white guy in the grape.
Yeah. The grape. Oh.
No, yeah. Wait, it's a song?
Oh, I remember this.
Now, this is a Fruit of the Womb commercial?
Yeah.
What happened to this?
So I wear Hanes now. When all the underwear had poo.
And Ray stripes all on through. Well, you got it too.
You rocking Fruit of the Loomies?
I'm rocking Fruit of the Loomies right now.
I got
Hanes.
Festivus for the rest of us. Christmas Seinfeld underwear on right now.
I got a Hanes wife beater on now.
I got a Lucky wife beater.
Guys, am I the only one? Am I the only one that stuck true to our boys?
I got Lucky.
When you shit your pants, you got that Fruit of the Loom.
This is a banger commercial, bro.
Guys. And this is why I rock them, okay?
You're telling me everybody's going backwards, but Fruit of the Womb is going forwards, bro. It's a simile.
You're telling me they're...
It's a metaphor, man.
Oh, they're doing fucking Abbey Road right there, bro.
You think...
This is better than the Beatles.
Dude, they're dropping the best commercial in the world. You think you really, you guys aren't really going to wear them? It's fucked up.
Not gonna lie, I might be wearing them because this is Seinfeld like boxers I got from Walmart. I feel like it might have a Fruit of the Womb tag in the back.
Could be a little Fruit of the Womb boy.
I'd have to rip my underwear off to find out though. How long is this commercial? Like 2 minutes?
It's gotta be wrapping up.
This is the entire commercial break.
It's probably a Super Bowl commercial.
Honestly, yeah.
Yeah. Back when commercials used to go fucking hard.
The fruit guys.
Yeah. Blues collection, man.
You know how far that? I was wearing blue underwear, blue for the moon this morning.
Hold on, pause it. Bro, they literally made an entire, like, fucking sad song just for the blue for the looms. I mean, that goes hard. That's dedication to the brand.
Mm-hmm.
Back to Fortnite.
No one does it like they do.
I know, bro. Doritos used to go hard as fuck on commercials during the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
And M&M's.
Everybody,
Taco Bell.
You remember the sexy and I know it M&M's commercial where he ripped his skin off and started like humping the air?
Yeah.
Remember the Skittles commercial where the guy was fucking his wife or the bride?
No.
He just got married and
That's
like,
cute.
Yeah. He's like, look it up. It was like Skittles wedding commercial. And it's like the dude just banging his fucking wife after he got married. And comes Skittles rainbow everywhere.
That rules, man.
Yeah.
I'm public access.
The third one. Oh, is it?
This is a guy playing on a PS3.
He had it saved.
He had it saved to his PS3.
Oh, this ain't the full one. Oh, it's just a theme.
No, I remember this commercial, bro.
The fuck?
What the fuck? Yeah, all right, we saw it. We saw it. I think that's all we need. It's going to be another guy's it's going to be his guy's Xbox 360. No.
Is this the kid?
Yeah, they fucked on the first one. Now they're having the kid, and it's obviously all Skittles, because he comes Skittles. Damn. What is up with this fucking shit, dude? Is it just a package of Skittles that he pulled out of her pussy?
Just a giant Skittle.
What the fuck, yo? Oh my god, let me eat your umbilical cord, Skittles. Is this when they added orange to Skittles?
She's eating the Skittles.
Bro, that...
Peanut butter?
What?
Oh! Oh!
That's my little peanut butter baby, huh? Look at this guy.
Oh, that's where Zach got it from. Zach always says, like, peanut butter baby. And, like, Toby, like, and all of his friends say it. That's where they got it from, the Skittles commercial.
It was a Reese's Pieces commercial, actually.
Oh, Reese's Pieces.
But they stole it from the Skittles commercial where that guy was fucking his wife.
Yeah, it was the same dude.
It's the same guy.
Dude, that's depressing.
Zach
man
always says that. He's like, "What's my little peanut butter baby?" And I'm like,
"All right, I think that's enough Skittles,
yeah,
man.
That's enough of that."
Is it cold in
here?
Yeah,
well,
come on, put it on, Jimmy.
Yeah,
is it cold in here?
Yeah, it is the couple from the first one,
is
right?
Is it cold in here? Get ready for my sweetness. Get ready for my sweetness.
Ooh, it's about to come, it's about to come, it's about to come. Ooh.
Oh, all over you. Share the rainbow. Taste the rainbow.
Dude, that fucking rules.
That fucking
rules.
that's
the best thing I've seen since Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles.
Commercial. Yep.
And hell yeah, dude. That rule is almost as much as that Camel Joe sign, dude.
Mm-hmm.
They need to, like, unnerf the cars in Fortnite again. I want Tricked Out back so bad.
They don't have Tricked Out?
No, they've got rid of it.
On some real shit, though, I need you guys to come with me there, because you guys would be able to help me pick out good shit. They
yeah, dude. I mean, I told you to grab me an airbrushed Bart Simpson t-shirt and a pair of fake Travis Scott dunks.
They didn't have any.
Yes, they did.
No, they didn't.
It's a flea market. No, they didn't. It's a fucking flea market.
They were there.
They had an airbrushed Bart Simpson. They had one.
You just didn't look.
You didn't flip through the airbrush section, did ya? God damn it.
Actually,
lazy
did.
Fuck.
They had Rick and Morty.
Oh.
I would have taken Rick and Morty.
Didn't you know him, bro?
I was saying, though.
But they definitely had the fake Travis in your line.
When we were there, I was saying, I was like, oh my god, I was like, this place would be so bad for Jake.
Would you just buy a bunch of dumb shit?
Because that's, like, the place for Jake, because he loves stupid shit, so he would spend all of his money in, like, one go.
Is this a plain donut?
Yeah, of course it is.
What's wrong with them, dude? I'm going to eat it, but I hate them for this.
Do it, dude.
It has a little bit of chocolate on it.
You're eating it out of pity?
Mm.
You're saving the rest of us.
Who the fuck thought this was a good idea?
They always put it inside the dozen. There's always one.
The only good plain donuts are from Big Apple.
Why would you even
You know the Big Apple? Where's that in, like, Mendon or some shit? Norfolk?
New York. No, it's in Brentham.
Big Apple.
It's in Norfolk.
Yeah, Norfolk.
It's in the woods of Norfolk. It's, like, right over the line.
Dude, there's... They're playing donuts?
There's a church.
Fire. But, other than that, fuck Dunkin'.
The only, like, donut shop I've ever been to that wasn't, like, Dunkin' or Honeydew or whatever is PV Donuts. They got, like, fat-ass, like, fucking nice donuts.
Yeah,
I have, like, the Fruit Loops one, or not Fruit Loops, Fruity Pebbles.
That's pretty legit.
It's pretty all right,
dude,
man.
Dude, I went to some restaurant the other day.
Yeah.
Dude, oh, yeah? That's crazy, bro.
The proportions, like, the portion sizes are too big.
Was that, I think I saw that mac and cheese or something.
Dude, yeah. Literally, the bowl was the size of this fucking, as wide as this.
How'd you do?
I ate a quarter of it, dude, and the to-go box was, like, this big and filled to the top.
I feel like that's what restaurants are about.
Do you eat the leftovers or someone eat out of your
Ricky,
fridge?
Ricky actually just ate it right.
That's what I was gonna say.
Dude, fucking, I should have just fucking shared one. Fucking, you could share. We could all share one and still fucking.
I told you how I felt like a beta the other day because I tried to go or yesterday because I went to Tuxbury's and I forgot.
Yeah.
It closed at 3 and I showed up at 3:20.
Oof.
My whole day was fucked up from
that's
that.
That's fucked. Then you were hungry.
Dude, you know what's hype? You remember after you guys, when you guys left, my order got fucked up?
Yeah, your Domino's.
So I drove to Domino's. I bitched them out.
Yep.
As one does.
As you gotta do.
And they were like, you wanna, like, they fixed my order, obviously. They, like, fucking gave me the shit I wanted. And they're like, you wanna keep the other shit? And I was like, fuck yeah, I wanna keep the other shit. So I got mad food for, like, free.
That's awesome. What did they mess up about it?
They gave me, all right, so I ordered, like, the... You know, like the deal they got for like $20 where it's like two mediums, fucking thing of like the bread parmesan bread things and the twisties. So I got pepperoni pizza and a bacon pizza and then those. And they gave me a large extra cheese pizza and a fucking mushroom and pineapple pizza. Dude, you know what's crazy too? When I got back, I was like, yo, anyone want this disgusting fucking pizza? And who do you think ate it?
Orion.
Yep. Orion was like, I would love a mushroom and pineapple pizza.
That's horrendous.
Because we were literally like...
I mean, like a mushroom and onion wouldn't be too bad, but mushroom and pineapple...
Or even just regular, like fucking pineapple and, like, ham. Like, how you should... Like, there's, like... I don't know, dude. And we were saying on the way home, we were like, damn, should we, like, give it to, like, a homeless person? I was like, no, not even a homeless person wants this garbage.
But
like,
Orion would love it.
The worst pizza... Like, dude, that's how you get punched by a homeless man, is giving them a pineapple
and mushroom pizza. That's how you lose your two front teeth.
And I was like, the only person that would possibly want this is the guy that ordered it. And no, Orion was like, hell yeah.
Orion's
again,
it was me.
Yeah.
Was it Orion that ordered it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude.
Yeah, dude.
Yeah. It was shitty though. Like I ordered delivery for a reason. I had to go. I had to go drunk drive there, and fucking.
It's not gonna get fixed otherwise.
I just tried calling the delivery driver like as soon as he left, and he'd fucking answer. And then I saw the schmuck in there.
No, that fucking bastard.
Dude, fuck him.
You should
should have
fucking thrown.
This isn't the Italian cuisine that I remember.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's not what you were promised.
Real Domino's motherfuckers wouldn't do that to me.
Nope. Their cinnamon twist started to die.
Some half-assed Domino's, man.
Those cinnamon twists, bro. Mm.
Fuck. I'm big on the Parmesan bites, dude. I get garlic dipping sauce with that. Dip some Parmesan.
Yeah, I mean, they're good. They're decent.
They're fucking good, dude.
I would rather garlic knots and cinny twists.
See, here's my hard time. Is like, I can't... It's either I'm eating the fucking cinnamons and I'm not eating much else. Maybe a slice or two. But, like, if I eat all the Parmesan bites, I can still finish my pizza because it's the same vein. The cinnamon is too desserty. Once I've eaten dessert, I'm done.
You know what my thing is?
Bro, it's a good mix.
You know what my thing is?
It.
Like, I can, like, eat a bunch of food, but then I hit that point where I can't eat it, but I can eat, like, dessert after a bunch of dessert.
No, I can't. Like, when I go out to eat, I never get dessert.
I get dessert all the time.
Same. Never, dude.
I get dessert all the time.
I get appetizers, and then I get my meal, and then I'm out.
I get appetizers, can't meal, eat after and that. Dessert, dude. All three.
You ain't getting a fucking hearty enough meal, dude.
Nah, bro.
It's not hearty enough for you, man.
It's always room for
you. You don't have no Jeff Hardy, Matt Hardy deals. You ain't got no Hardy Boys deals. Your meals, well, not, usually split your meals set, ain't, so ain't solving out. No crimes in children's books, man. You ain't got no hearty. You ain't got no hearty meals, bro.
Dude, I got this tiramisu the other
That's
day.
That's the right word I'm using, right? It was
fucking fantastic.
Dude. I can't split desserts because I'm like, three, dude, got, I'm like, I want all of it. So
well, it's because you're getting carrot cake and you know that's your favorite meal.
Me?
Yeah, I know you're getting carrot cake.
No, like, even now, like...
Bro, I know you're getting carrot cake.
Not all places got carrot cake.
Bro, I know you're getting carrot cake. And if you're not getting carrot cake, you're getting the cheesecake, buddy.
I don't eat just cheesecake.
Buddy, I know you're getting carrot cake.
What about a couple
cream? Bro, I can eat fucking chocolate cake if I want, okay?
What about a little tiramisu?
I can eat tiramisu!
Why do you mean tiramisu?
Because tiramisu is fucking awesome.
What is tiramisu?
It's like coffee.
It's like coffee, cake, fucking pudding, bro.
It's gas. Mm.
It's gas.
I'm not a huge
And it's like a
guy.
Very, you like,
shut
airy,
your mouth,
it's like
bro.
A fluffy texture.
I like it a lot
like
more
airy.
Than Jell-O.
I'm telling you, man.
I'll say that.
Cameron, I'm telling you, next time you take your lady out and you see
Jell-O.
The dessert
Jell-O.
Menu,
I'm not
and you see the tiramisu, you should be like,
I'm not
maybe we should split
Jimmy,
this.
You know what it is? It's because I don't drink coffee.
It doesn't taste like fucking coffee. It's fucking a dessert. It's excellent.
You're yelling at me for points I didn't even have. I eat a coffee dessert all the time.
Good.
I get mocha fraps all the time. Like, I love a nice, like, coffee, ice cream, cakey type of deal.
That's, I'm glad.
I just don't like fucking coffee on its own. And I don't think that's that weird.
Drink
no,
black
it's
coffee
really
today
good,
bro. Cause I'm a good, amazing.
It's good because you've beaten it into yourself the same way people say that beer is good. You have to literally,
fucking
like, you
what?
Have to drink it 7 times and be like, and then
no,
eventually you're like,
good.
No, it's bitter as shit. Coffee sucks, dude. Nah, that's why you have to go there and be like, can I get 8 sugars, 25 caramel?
Me? I get my coffee black.
Yeah, I know. Listen, I understand you like your coffee like you like your ladies, man, but I don't. I don't like that coffee like I don't like my ladies. Black.
Damn.
That's a good analogy.
What about like a nice, Asian coffee?
Yeah, what about a nice Asian coffee?
Huh?
Hell yeah, dude. Watch anime, drink a nice Asian coffee.
Yeah.
Sorry, I don't like my fucking my drink to be too bitter and annoying.
Grow up.
You grow up.
Grow up. Drink a fucking cup of coffee.
Dude, I was ragging on Cassidy last night. It was so fun because she didn't. She like did it accidentally. Like she didn't realize, but I immediately clocked it and noticed it. She like we were in the car waiting for the food last night at Domino's, and I was like, and she like locked the doors because she realized they weren't locked. But as soon as she did that, a black guy hopped out of his car next to me, and then I was like, why'd you do that? You scared? And then I was just ragging on her for like 20 minutes while she's like
awesome.
Trying to defend that. She's like, I didn't see the black guy. I swear, I was like,
oh,
nah,
you
I mean,
didn't.
He just seems like a nice black guy. Like, I don't know what the problem is. Why are we locking the doors? And then she was like, I what? And then eventually I was like, all right, but I'm seriously going to get out of here because this black guy's scaring the shit out of me. dude, it was fun. I love that shit. Traps, man.
Traps. It was easy.
Racist traps.
It is what it looks like.
Mm. Scary.
Scary.
Very.
I am afraid.
Be afraid.
I was watching a show. It's called like 100. I think it's like 100.
100 gecks.
Yeah, 100 gecks. I was listening
to
100 gecks, and yeah, it was super.
Thousand
super
ways
racist.
To die.
But no, it was like they did like a test subject on. It was like a Netflix show, and they had like 100 different people, and they had them testing like a bunch of different studies and stuff. So
like autistic or something.
No, like social things. Like what would you do? Fucking with their mind a little bit. And they did one where it was like, all right, we're going to give you a fake gun.
Yep.
And there's going to be people that are unarmed and people that are armed, that have, like, people with a cell phone and people with a gun popping out, and you got to point and click at which one as fast as you can. And they, like, but what they didn't tell them is that, like, the races were, like, a big part of it. Like, it'd be, like, a black guy with a phone and then a white guy with a gun would pop out.
Mm-hmm.
And, dude, there was this one white chick that she only shot the black guy. And then she's just, like, breaking down crying because the whole world knows she's racist now. Oh, I ruled, dude.
That's
just,
nice.
She was like, I swear. And, like, they, like, threw in that one of the guys that hopped out was, like, a dude that's been working on the set with them for weeks and they know his face and like all that. And she's like, I killed my black friend. dude. Yeah, they really got him with that. Like, everything else, nothing else in it was, like, race-based, but they just got him. They're like, let's see out of all these fucking people who's racist. And it was all, like, younger white girls that always ended up shooting him.
You're scared. Mm.
Good show. So you said you were watching fucking How to Build a Sex Room?
Yeah.
You done with it yet, or?
No.
How's it, where are you at?
Same place. I
don't, dude, the gay guys, that's it? That's how all you've watched?
Yeah, it's like and six. And that first couple? In.
Nah, I thought yeah, like the is. Gay it's couple was like three episodes.
I watched like four or five episodes.
I think there's, what, eight episodes of it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. You watch it?
No.
She'll watch it. Sleeping, some old British lady.
Dude, I want those throw pillows.
She like fucking makes like room for motherfuckers. Fuck.
Dude, you know those throw pillows she always throws in?
Like weird. She asked the couple, she's like, how do you guys like fucking?
How you guys like the fuck?
She like really figures them out. They're like, we just like this. She's like, nah, you really like this.
How about I pull out the flogger on your ass?
Yeah, and then she has a little bag, like a little purse, and it's just
filled with gear.
Gear.
Filled with gear, dude.
Filled with gear.
Tactical gear.
She's on fucking hella cycle. Nah, it's filled with fucking dildos, fucking ass plugs, handcuffs, fucking.
I don't know about butt plugs, man.
It was ever.
Not for me.
I don't think that's for a lot of people. Like, even you know how big those things are? Dude. Oh.
Well, they were like.
Small. They like.
I feel like it hurt more to pull it out.
Dude, I feel like I got so much shit in my ass all the time that my ass is already plugged up.
Yeah, dude. I got the dookie plug. Ugh. What was up with that? Remember, like, this year in France or whatever, they had that Christmas tree butt plug in, like, the center of their town?
That's pretty cool.
It was, like, a big green butt plug for some reason.
Oh, I remember that. Yeah.
And it's like...
That's in Cambridge, right?
Shit, man. And I thought it was in, like, France.
Oh, it might have been.
I was like, don't kids live around there or something? Like, then you have the conversation. It's like, oh, we're going to go to the town and see, like, them putting the star on the tree. And then they just unveil that it's a big butt plug. And you're like, your kids are like, what's that?
It's in Paris.
Yeah. The fuck? Why? Like, I get it.
Well, we got the two Martin Luther dick statue.
Yeah. Well, no, I don't think it looks like a dick. I think it looks like... Martin Luther's holding a big piece of poop.
Yeah, that's
the one in Boston?
Yeah.
I haven't seen it yet. I gotta go see the big poopy Martin Luther King statue.
I didn't go up close to it yet. I haven't gone up close to it yet, but I saw it.
Well, yeah, because it smells, man.
Yeah. I was in the poopy truck, and I was afraid that my hose might have sucked it up, and it wasn't fine.
How dare you disgrace the MLK poopy statue?
Dude, that would be a fire picture. But it would get so much hate.
We should go do our podcast pick there, dude.
Taking the list and portables picture, like having the hose and holding it next to the dookie.
That's how we should take the podcast pick. Have you holding the hose up next to it. I'll like stand far away and make it look like I'm pooping it out.
Maybe I can like...
Yeah. You're sniffing
it. You're wiping.
You're sniffing. Yeah, you're wiping my butt while I poop it out. Consistently while I'm pooping, you're wiping. Mm-hmm. Wouldn't that be nice to have a little dude... Like a little toilet goblin.
That's what kings did back in the day.
No,
they didn't wipe their own ass. They had like a dude that.
You remember, like in the Flintstones, dude, like their garbage disposal was that like
get my ass
thing?
Clean, but don't fuck it up. You know what I mean?
No, like you remember
like,
in the Flintstones?
I'm fucking up my own ass by accident.
Their garbage disposal was like a pig under the sink.
That's pretty neat. Yeah.
So like, what about like a little like bird, a little like pterodactyl looking bird thing that just chills in the hole in the toilet?
Like Flintstones.
And just fucking like. Num, num, num,
num, what if wipes all? You. What if all furniture and like. Technology was just dinosaurs.
That
like
would
the
rule,
Flintstones,
man.
Bro.
I would love, like, dude, imagine if we could find, like somehow restored dinosaur skin and then get, like, a pair of boots and a jacket made out of a T-Rex, dude. Holy
first
fuck.
First thing we do.
Holy fuck, dude. Yeah, the first dinosaur we bring back, it goes haywire, so we just kill it and make a fuck ton of designer ass.
Coats and boots.
Fucking dinosaur ass, you know what I mean?
Designosaur. Designosaur.
They call me a designosaur.
Designosaur.
Bitch, I got dyslexia. I got that designosaur. You know what I mean?
Yo.
Dripping like a designosaur with my dyslexic ass.
I got T-Rex.
My T-Rex's ass. My T-Rexic.
I'm T-Rexic.
Everything every time I see words, it turns into dinosaur names.
No, like no, T-Rex, like Tourette's.
Every time, no. Yeah. No, like fucking, T-Rexia, like fucking dyslexia.
Yeah, but like T-Rex, like Tourette's.
Yeah, and it's just like
T-Rex.
Yeah, so like the.
No, it's like he's just talking like normal, and then he has like his tick is like. He just like does the little T-Rex fucking arms. Honest. Yeah, dude.
That's a good twist on it. Instead of like dinosaur noise, the T-Rex on it.
Yeah. Fuck! You know?
Yeah.
You ever seen the dude that has it like really bad? And like, he has like TikToks where he's going on, like, my first time going out on a date with my wife in public with as a man with Tourette's. And it's like, dude, how is she even with this man? Because he just, like, he has the type of like Tourette's where it's just like, you say anything that comes to your mind. Yeah. So, like, the waitress walks up and he's like, I like the titty, fuck you. Can I get, Oh, you got a fucking fat ass. Sorry about that. Your tits. It's like, dude, how the fuck do you even, like.
That's great.
Like, how do you fall in love with that guy? There's no way, like, every 2 seconds he's like.
He's quirky.
I want to squirt in your mouth. Yeah, so I grew up in fuck me in the ass, Tennessee. Like, there's no way. Like, I'd get so pissed off.
He's quirky,
bro. Nah, dude. There's something wrong with that chick. There's something definitely wrong with that chick. You know. He's quirky. It's like you can't.
I'm actually one of the best speakers of my class. Motherfucker, cunt.
I'd love to see a TED talk with a dude that severe ass. Tourette's, and it goes on for like 5 hours, and it's only supposed to be like a 30-minute. Dude, that'd be the best, honestly. Think about like
if you're
like
time a little bit.
No, think about if you're like a comic that has Tourette's, you only have to write a 15, and you can have an hour. Cause you're just every 3 words, you're like fuck my ass.
Yeah, you're just ticking.
And you'd kill too, because they'd just be waiting for it. They'd be like, oh, what's he gonna say next? This lady in the front row has a huge set of titties. You know?
You could.
So what's the deal with the weather?
Well, anyways, I was on a plane last week. The waitress had a fat pussy! Excuse me. You can't figure out what's the joke and what's not.
Yeah.
Oh, dude, that would kill.
That would kill.
That's like Dave Williamson. He only has to write like 15 minutes of actual jokes because the rest is just talking about how you're a midget. You gotta have a stick, man. Like, there's that comic that is, like, full-blown paraplegic.
Yeah.
And it's, like, it's like slow comedy because, you know, he has to type it out.
Yes.
He has to think it with his mind so his transmitter can dispute it. I don't know.
It tracks his eyeball. That's how Stephen Hawking did it.
I had a kid
The computer tracks his eyeball on a screen, and that's how it chooses.
I had a kid like
legs.
That in my elementary school, and I think he had the same type of thing. But, like, half the time it'd just be him, like, because like I don't think he was really like caring. Like, I don't think he was trying to say anything. He was just looking, and it like tracked it, and it just be like.
There was a kid in Foxborough that had progeria, that like aging disease.
I don't know why, but I feel like in elementary school I went to school with so many freaks, like.
And elementary school, there was a kid that had MS.
I wonder if they just died before, like, the summer
what
before
the fuck
middle
is
school.
Wrong with your elementary school, dude? All my kids that I went to school.
I had a bitch when I went to my McGuire
and
Providence.
We had a bunch of special needs kids in my class.
Dude, my school was like.
And in elementary school, they weren't really that separated.
Even the middle school, there was a shitload, but we didn't see them a lot because they had their own class.
Well, in Attleboro too. I meant like when I was in Attleboro, there was like none.
Went to Attleboro High.
No, middle school. Elementary school.
And the special needs kids weren't really that separated. They were still in our class.
See, like, I had, like, a bitch that had a full-blown, like, hunchback in my elementary school.
Dang.
Like, and I think she just died eventually, because, like, it was really bad. Like, she always was like, you know? And she, like, talked all weird. I also, like, went to, like, retarded preschool. Like, with, like, a bunch of fucking fucked up fucks.
A bunch of retards? Cool.
Yeah.
I'm not one of you.
Get me out of here.
Get me out of here. No.
I don't belong here. There's a man trapped in a smart man trapped in a Downs kid's body.
Yep. He gets mind swapped.
Get me out of here. Dude, that's the Freaky Friday I want to see.
Yeah.
A Down syndrome kid and an autistic kid switch bodies.
It's Freaky Friday.
It's like, what was that, the meme comes through where it's like the guy and he's like, wait, am I retarded? And then he looks in the mirror.
Oh, yes.
And it's like a fucking straight up Downs kid.
Yes, that's a classic.
Can I hit one of your Chris Benoit's?
You can hit mine, but it's a little fucked, dude, because it doesn't thread in, because I stripped the threads out, so you just gotta, like, hold it in.
Why didn't you put Teflon on this? You're a plumber.
I could try that.
But you didn't even think about it?
It's all fucked up.
You didn't even think about it.
It doesn't even thread in at all. It doesn't even want to thread in.
You know, I still to this day believe that Teflon tape, the blue monster, is the reason my ear blew out that one time.
Really?
Yeah. Because I think there was, like, it was bunched up and it sliced the inside of my ear.
It's pretty soft, but
so
maybe.
So then I switched to just using the rubber rings to size up because that shit, I didn't trust it anymore.
Fair enough, man. That's fine. You know more than I.
Dude, I got, like,
that lessons. Car's from the dispensary.
I'm on wrestling TikTok, as you know.
Yes.
As you can assume, as you can all
as
assume.
As I can assume, you are on wrestling TikTok.
I have, like, a less respect for Chris Benoit. Not obviously. Obviously not because of the coolest thing he ever did, which is kill his wife.
He's one of the best technical wrestlers to ever perform in the WWE.
He bullied The Miz. When The Miz got into wrestling, he, like, severely bullied him in the locker room, I guess. And The Miz was, like, changing in, like, bathrooms and shit. Him and JBL, which I've...
Call that a cock!
Well,
like, shit like that?
I guess The Miz was, like, eating chicken in the locker room one day before the show. And then Chris Benoit came up and he was like, what the fuck? You eating like right next to my fucking bag. He was like, you're getting chicken grease all over the place. And then like JBL just chimed in. He was like, get the fuck out of here. And then he wasn't allowed in the locker room until The Undertaker told Chris Benoit to shut the fuck up.
Nice.
And told JBL to suck his dick.
Nice.
And then Tombstone Piledrive both of them.
At the same time.
Yeah, man. And I love The Miz, so it just hurt a little. But, you know, Chris Benoit, still legend.
Still legend.
Put still one of the best technical wrestlers of all time. Dude, I'm
in
like,
and out of the ring.
It's like, I've just been getting so deep in wrestling lore. Like, did you know about Perk Angle? Kurt Angle?
Yeah.
Kurt Angle?
Is he on Perkies?
Look up Perk Angle highlights. Like, P-E-R-C. Because, basically... Kurt Angle got kicked out of the WWE, went to TNA because he was off the Perkies. And then he tried to get into UFC and they didn't let him in because he was off the Perkies. But he's the fucking man. Does it say Perk Angle?
Yeah.
Okay, cool. Because it's going to have like trap music with it. So I just keep on getting Perk Angle clips, man.
Today's video is sponsored by Opera GX.
No, it's not. We're not sponsored by anything. Skip to Perk Angle. Jesus, man, this ad goes on for a while. What the fuck? Where is Perk Angle? Okay, here we go.
I love Prime Kurt Angle. All right.
Pause. Look up Perk Angle highlight with Baby Tron.
Baby Tron.
Or anything like that. Like rap. Perk Angle rap highlights.
Okay.
I don't know. I've been seeing a lot of them. So they have to be out there. Yep, here we go. These have been my pride and joy.
He's dead.
He was the shit, dude. I mean, look at how crazy these clips are. That was him trying to fuck Booker T's bitch.
This goes hard.
You know he wrestled this entire time? He couldn't turn his neck, dude. like to the right. He like fully broke his neck in wrestling in high school and continued to do this.
Damn.
Like people say that like it's almost impossible. Like because he had a bunch of fucked up shit. That's why he's always off the perkies, man.
He had to.
He was off the perkies right here, dude. It's him having a woo off.
He's having a woo off.
He's chugging milk. That's you.
That's
every
me.
Day. That's you every day at dinner.
But I never have enough.
Yeah, man. So that's been my shit lately. I'm getting deep in the war, man. Kurt Angle off them perkies, dude. Oh. Yeah, just leave this shit on, dude. You don't have to play the volume or anything, but just, yeah. Yeah. I feel like I had that Gap hoodie when I was a kid.
Maybe so.
Alright, man.
Can you get a bit tinted but your papa pump?
Dude, I've been seeing hard ass Mick Foley clips too.
Mick Foley.
I guess after WWE like released him, he went to like the most brutal league he could possibly find in Japan, and they would have like full blown nail table matches.
It looks so fast.
And like they would replace.
Look at how fast it looks without the music on.
Yeah. Right. But yeah, he went to a league where they'd replace the ropes all the time with barbed wire, like real barbed wire. And he was just getting fucked up and bleeding all over the place. Ruled.
That's sick.
I met that dude at Coco Key.
Coco Key?
Who was the comic that was working at Coco Keys? Do you remember that? We talked about it on the pod a while ago with a comic, and he said that he could just... he could... he said there was a fact that Mick Foley went there because he worked there.
Brandon Pyers.
It was Brandon Pyers? All right, bet. I was trying to figure that out last night. I thought it was AJ Farrow, but then I was like, there's no way AJ Farrow was working there. He's, like, not that much older than us.
No, it was Brandon Pyers.
Dude, I've been fucked up all week, my nostrils, man. Dude, it's too much, dude. You should see my fucking car right now. It's ridiculous. This is why I miss having a beige car, bro. I've been in the talks about wrapping my car with beige.
Oh, really?
Yeah, dude. No, getting a full beige wrap.
No.
It may be just like...
My cousin's boyfriend does wraps.
Oh, for real?
Can you wrap
Does police? He do custom ones, too? Because I've been thinking about maybe doing a beige with a Tony Soprano accent.
Yeah, you can probably...
Like, just like pictures of him.
Yeah, you can probably
collaged up. With Tony Hawk.
Yeah.
It's expensive, though.
I don't care.
It's like $3,000, $4,000. If you're doing
I'll get a loan. I'm going to get a loan to wrap this shit. Noise. I bet he cut me a deal for it being so fire. Tony Hawk and Tony Soprano with the beige background. I mean, come on. Mm. I bet I could come in there and be like, look, I got $1,500.
I got it.
And he's going to be like, no. And I'm like, wait.
Wait.
Beige, Tony Soprano, Tony Hawk rap. And he's going to be like, 800. And I'll be like, bet. You know what I mean?
Yeah. He'll be like, you got me.
You got me, you son of a bitch.
You fucking fuck.
That was like me in the tattoo studio the other day. I got fucking inspired on and I was like, I got 150. And he's like, that's my minimum. I was like, I want this big ass spider traditional. And he was like, I.
Mm-hmm. 150. Not a penny more.
Not a penny more, not a penny. Actually, I paid him 160 because I tip.
Tip 10 bucks.
Yeah, dude.
Because you're a fucking gentleman.
Yeah, dude. Because I'm the fucking man.
Because you're the fucking... Because you're a sweetheart.
What are you talking about, dude? I'm fucking the man, dude.
Because you're a sweetheart.
I wish there was a perk thing that could rhyme with my name. That would be so cool.
Perk.
There. None of us can have perk names. It doesn't work.
Nope.
None of our names rhyme with perk.
Nope.
I could be Zan O'Neill. That's not as cool. Zans are not as cool with perks, dude. Being off the perk and doing crazy shit. That's a vibe. We gotta get Perk Angle on, dude.
Yeah, well, I wonder what Perk Angle's doing right now.
Popping perks?
I think he's doing, dude.
I wonder what his back's doing. I wonder what his neck's doing.
Not good, dude.
Terrible. He's
fucking
dead.
Awful. In recession. What's Kurt? I don't know how he moved. Like, he was a high flyer, too. Like, you saw him doing backflips off that steel cage. Let's get more Perk Angle highlights. Can you just get in the background? We don't even need music. Just Kurt Angle highlights. He was the man, dude. He would do that. He was like a king of doing the, like, getting caught saying gay shit. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? You know that vein of wrestling where they'll be like, you did what with a man? And you'll be like, oh.
Yeah.
It's like when they got Vince McMahon. It's like, you hate pigs. I hate pigs.
I love pigs. You hate roosters. I love roosters. You hate cocks. I love cock.
Oh, dude, we'll get fucking Kurt Angle
Perk,
going off.
Perk Sammy.
Perk Angle.
Perk Angle, dude.
Reloaded. Perk off Sammy. A beam.
Dude, imagine how good that must feel. A beam, feeling nothing. Flying. Flying on dudes.
Don't feel a fucking thing, pretending like you do.
Yeah. Dude, he's off the beams. He's off the beams, bro. Addiction.
Put the sound on.
What did he say there with the gun thing? Rewind it a little bit. I want to. Was during our childhoods. He gave us some of our most memorable moments in wrestling. Oh, it's a British guy.
Fuck.
Not Marky D 123. All right, shove it, squad. I got another big one today, and I'm not talking about the Hawks Generals. Recently on YouTube, Perk Angle videos have gained popularity. Us. Recently on my TikTok, Perk Angle videos have been popping up everywhere. Tristan Tate watching Perk Angle videos. Wait, hold on, pause. Save, you've been seen.
Perk Angle.
Yo, Andrew, have you been seeing the Perk Angle videos?
Bro, all these Perk Angle videos have been popping up on my feed all day.
Oi.
I don't know how to feel. Like, he's just jumping off the thing. Like, you know how fucking sick
that
is.
But in reality, when you think about it, he really was off the perks.
He was off the beans.
Tristan, he was 100% off the perks.
He was off the beans. I remember when we were young, we would wrestle. We'd wrestle, you know, in our $1,000 ring in the basement.
Yeah.
Because, you know, our dad was also an amateur wrestler, as you know.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, he actually met Perk Angle, and we hung out with him. You know, that's why, you know, smoking weed, drinking.
He actually taught us to kickbox.
It's not cool, right? It's not cool, but the perkies that he was off, it made him
unbelievable.
It made him a god.
Fucking legend.
Perk Angle was the man.
Fucking legend, bruv.
Bruv. Perky, what? Let's watch more Perk Angle clips. Hold on, is there audio here?
No.
Of him talking? When he was sipping on a dangerous cocktail each night. The cocktail was Soma, Xanax, and alcohol. Try and order in that in your local pub. In 2013, he actually got help. Xanax and alcohol? So I'm sure that there's many of you like me that are watching. Pause. Oh, I remember Perk Angle off the Xanax and the alcohol. I mean, how cool.
Jeff Hardy, look at that.
Jeff Hardy, another fellow drug addict in wrestling. Oh, they're wrestling in TNA there, too.
Yeah.
They both got caught with the perkies because they started drug testing around 2012. I don't know. There was a certain point in time where they just started drug testing and so many wrestlers went to TNA. Like, Sting went. Like, they were just all off the perkies. Because they needed it. All the high flyers pretty much dipped.
They popped a couple beans.
Kurt on a perk. Yeah, it's like a sleuth on a stoop or whatever. Kurt on a perk.
I think his neck's broken, dude.
Kurt on a perk. Off the perk.
Cannot be not off the perk. Hey, cutie patootie.
You got any bolas in that bitch yet? How have we not stocked up on the bolas?
The fucking Olympic champion.
He genuinely was an Olympic champion.
Don't ever forget it. The Olympic champion.
He was an Olympic wrestling champion. Dude, that's him and Chris Benoit right there.
DC?
DC. You calling Diet Cokes DCs? It's pretty chill.
It's fucking...
I'll take a DC, dude. Hell yeah. I've always been a Diet Coke man, dude. And I you know what?
I'll take a DC.
I've been closeted for a while. Hey, I feel you like want a DC? Are you good? It's hard to bring up that you like Diet Coke sometimes.
I choose not to drink them most of the time.
They're kind of better. They're a little better.
Shut up.
I don't know, dude. I think it's because my mom drank DCs, dude.
My mom drinks DCs.
Everybody's mom. Your mom drink DCs, dude?
My mom drinks DPs.
Diet Dr. Pepper?
No, Diet Pepsi.
Diet Pepsi?
I was drinking a...
What about a DDP?
I was drinking one earlier.
What about DDP?
Diet Dr. Pepper, dude.
I was drinking one earlier. DDP.
You were drinking a Diet Dr. Pepper earlier?
Yeah.
Dude, my man's off it.
It's like a little slushy. It's nice.
Yeah, dude, that fucking Red Bull fridge slushes up drinks.
I like it.
That's pretty chill, man. I got my fucking DC and my mics, man. I'm fucking
shit. Who's that guy?
I don't know. Some fucking no name that Perk Angle absolutely wrecked. The dude.
The man. The Olympic champion.
I was talking this morning to Cassidy about how when I was a kid, I was legitimately scared of the wrestler Boogeyman. And I thought he was going to be under my bed.
Worms and cast.
He was always under the ring, bro, and shit would just go dark, and then the Boogeyman is there, and he's eating worms, and he's freaking everyone the fuck out, man. It was crazy. You think I'm not gonna think that guy's under my bed?
Dude, he 100% is, what do you mean?
I don't want
him. Dude, a couple years ago, I think it was 2 years ago, he was in the Royal Rumble, and they're like, no one knew who he was, and it hurt me. Like, I remember watching him, and I was like, no way. The Boogeyman is fucking coming in here.
No name Boogeyman.
And no one, like, cheered or anything. Fuck. Yo, you got tissues in this motherfucker? You're breaking your fucking mic right now? Hold it. You know what? You've been deemed holding it. Because if you can't... You know what? If you're going to break it all the time, I don't think you deserve it. I think Mike's stand privileges should be taken away.
Should be revoked. Like, look at that guy.
Dude, I mean, come on. That's a freak, man. That's a freak on a leash 100% right there.
He's fucking drooling.
Any word on the tissues down here, though? We don't got none?
What the fuck did I just do?
Why do we not have tissues in this, dude?
You don't have a tissue for your issue?
No.
No.
No, dude. I don't.
That's a fucked up world, man.
Fucking fucked up, I guess.
There's a bag of tissues right there, Nick. No way.
No way. For real?
What?
For real, for real. I'm gone,
is that tissues?
I don't see shit.
I don't see any tissues.
You lie? Look at this guy.
Dude, you're gonna make me scared, bro. It's dark in here. Yeah, this was a genuine fear of mine when I was a child.
It's a heart. It's a
heart. I'm the Boogeyman, and I'm gay.
I'm coming to fuck your ass, John Cena. John Cena is literally me.
Shook.
That's literally what I looked like when I was a kid.
Beijing.
That was me when I saw the Boogeyman when I was a kid.
What?
Bing-shuling.
Bing-shuling. Ni hao. Bing-shuling.
This is back when... Dude, fuck JBL, dude. This is the guy that bullied The Miz. He has some really funny shit, though. Like, there's clips of him, like... shooting promos where he's at the border trying to, like, capture Mexicans.
Nice.
And he had, like, a feud with Rey Mysterio, I believe, because he's Mexican.
A spoonful of sugar.
This is bad.
This is a bad mamma jamma, dude.
This is a bad man.
Is he missing his front teeth?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm the Boogeyman, and I'm coming out the closet.
Dude, I was scared that he was going to be in my closet, for sure.
Man,
Imagine there's just like a bunch of glass that went into the spoon while he ate it and just like cut his whole mouth open. Oh, what the fuck?
I'm the boogeyman, and I'm coming to fuck dudes.
Ha ha ha.
No. The boogeyman's gonna come and get him, dude. There's one where it's like a Hornswoggle is like scared to go under the ring.
Oh, shit.
And he's like, it's like DX is there, it's Triple H and Shawn Michaels. And just Triple H is like, you know, mute it so that it's not cast over. But Triple H, he's like, dude, it's gonna be fine. And he's like, what are you scared of? And he's like, points to, he's like, monster. And he's like, there's not monsters under there. Just, Sean, will you go check? And then Sean goes and checks, and he's like, oh, there's nothing under there. And then he gets pulled under, and like, fucking, he comes back out, and he's got worms in his mouth. And he's like, he like walks back in, he's like, what happened there? And just worms fall out, and then the boogeyman comes in, dude. Fucking terrifying.
Jesus.
You kidding me?
It's the fucking boogeyman.
And it's when you least expect it, man, because he was on ECW, and then he'd just pop in.
Yeah.
Scare the shit out of you on WWE.
Me.
Look at him, man. He's eating worms! Are you guys not scared right now?
I'm fucking shook to my core.
Okay, can you check behind the Metallica poster real quick? Dude, is he in there? That'd be the coolest. Imagine we went like an hour and then it turns out our special guest is the boogeyman.
You feel worms falling down. I was
like, oh, the beautiful forecast.
All of us have worms coming around. We're scared of shit. She's got some on her
face, bro.
What do you put on her face?
Bite-sized mole.
Is that Roddy Piper there? Why is Roddy Piper just chilling in the back? What the? Why is
he's
old?
He's like, ew, dude.
Old ass Roddy. Oh,
that's fucking gross.
Oh, he ate it off of her. Boys at the sleepover.
It's fucking awesome.
Oh my God! Dude, this shit used to just be built different, this whole show. What is it, like a piece of steak or something? Or chicken, probably, right?
Now he's fucking dancing. From parts unknown.
What is he looking at Roddy Piper for now? What is he gonna do to Hot Rod?
Spit it at him, dude.
Is Roddy Piper doing prayers right now? He's that scared? Yes. Dude, that's me as a child watching right there. Was he even Christian?
Yo, I was clean, like,
please help me,
man.
Jesus. Please, Jesus, don't let the boogeyman come under my bed tonight. Please. Alright, man, that's enough.
Yeah,
dude, I'm too scared right now to even think.
Booker T about to get fucking exposed.
Perk Angle was Booker T's worst nightmare, dude. He was always trying to fuck his bitch. Is that what Washington, D.C. stands for? Washington Diet Coke?
Yeah.
That is crazy, dude. Because
D.C. is the Diet Coke version of the state of Washington.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
You're right.
I believe that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I believe that Coca-Cola is running the entire government, honestly.
I believe it. They've been around long enough.
They have bases all over the place, man. They're running Pravi, bro.
They have factories in, like, every country in the world.
Coca-Cola, they're in every restaurant, every food place.
Not all of them.
Basically, everyone.
I bet they run Pepsi, bro.
Yeah, but those are like the fucking.
I bet
like,
they run
the
Pepsi
places,
and Apple.
Yeah, but
and
the
like,
Pepsi places are always like those like fucking like liberal fucking hipster fucking.
Dude, I'm gonna look into my liquor store and see if somehow it's run by Pepsi, dude. I'm gonna get to the source of it.
Coke.
Or not Pepsi, Coke. But yeah, dude. We gotta figure this shit out, dude. I just think that they shouldn't be trusted.
They definitely shouldn't.
Who? Hold on. Look up the. Can we get the fucking seat? Who? The big guy. What's the biggest? Who owns fucking Coca-Cola? Look up the guy who owns Coca-Cola. The CEO, whatever the fuck. Is he Chinese?
That guy?
What the fuck?
James Quincy?
Coca-Cola.
Well, yeah. He's not one sole owner, but rather the company's owned by thousands of shareholders and investors around the world.
So they say.
The largest shareholder is Warren Buffett. And
what's he famous for? Why does everyone know his name?
He's a big time famous businessman.
How do you become a famous businessman, though?
Because he's like hella rich. Like, fucking, like. It's like. That's like. It's like Jeff Bezos. He's a famous
businessman. Berkshire Hathaway's also a bank.
Yeah, but he owns Amazon. He's like the face of Amazon almost. So
Warren Buffett owns a lot of fast food, like, companies.
It is cool that you could get. Rich enough to just be like,
you know, everyone drink, you knows. You know, he drinks 6 Cherry Cokes a day, or it might be 6 Diet Cokes a day.
Yeah.
My thing is, fucking like, insane. Why do I even.
He eats like a fucking 5-year-old, Warren Buffett. He eats like Dairy Queen every morning. Well for him. He eats like, well, no, he eats McDonald's every morning. He eats like. He eats fast food like 3 times
like
a day.
He's like 90 years old, so good for him.
Fast food 3 times a day, Coke 6 times, well, when you 6 have, Cokes when a day.
You have your 2 adrenochrome baths.
Yeah, that is a day. True.
The like, Diet Cokes really get negated.
He eats candy all day long. Too.
When you have child blood transfusions,
you can fucking eat whatever you
can
want.
Eat whatever you want. Because you get revitalized like, with youth every day.
Honestly, yeah, because like even all those famous people, dude. I mean, that's just adrenochrome plus eating healthy. I mean, that's what those got. Like the movie stars.
There is literally.
Hold on, you want to know what? Listen, we want to get down to it. Everyone wants to know what the Rock's on. You want to know what the Rock's on?
What?
Adrenochrome.
Fucking adrenochrome mixed with fucking a little bit of test, a little bit of fucking super steroids from the CIA because he's fucking about to be president probably.
There's face cream you can buy that's literally made out of like fucking baby dicks. Like the circumcised skin. They like infuse that shit into it. It's crazy, bro.
Baby cream face. Baby dick face cream.
Baby dick cream face. Face cream.
Come on. You want to buy some baby dick face cream?
Babe, I'll be mentioned. I'm young. Some fucking baby dick cream on my face.
Look into it, bro. It's fucking real.
So you telling me if I rub a baby's dick against my face, they take
the skin from circumcisions. And they it's medical waste, and they take it, and they put it in the face
cream. Can I use it to jerk off?
You can't use the baby cream shit to jerk. Because then, listen, you can't, listen, wait. If you.
What is going on?
I'm thinking about it. If you use the baby dick face cream to jerk off, will your dick get younger? Will it shrink? Will it shrink, dude?
Or will it grow, or then, like, glow?
I don't know if it'll grow and glow, because, like, the adrenochrome. The fucking little kid blood and shit makes you younger, right?
Yes, apparently.
So if you use it on your dick, you transfuse that right in your dick, won't it shrink?
That's a sound theory. That makes sense if it means it would get younger.
If my dick is getting younger, that means it's getting smaller. But if you're a really old man, I guess it might just unwrinkle.
Yeah. You have to be at the right age to use it.
Yeah. You can't be 18 using the baby dick cream on your dick.
That's
because then that's gonna revert you back to 14 when you add a little 4-incher, dude.
You'll be at least 25.
Yeah. It's like renting a car.
Yeah, like renting a car. You gotta have a little bit of credit, a little bit of responsibility.
You got anything to weigh in on this? What do you mean though there's baby dick cream? I don't know what you're talking about.
I saw it on Ellen.
Of course Ellen knows about it. Ellen cuts the faces off of little children and makes her
face mask
her shit younger.
Penile facial.
Ellen is actually 1,000 years old.
Sandra Bullock got a penile facial. Wait till you see this shit.
I believe Ellen is using pussy.
And, like, probably, like, placentas and shit.
Mixed with baby face. and you just you stay munch a box and you yeah you just get younger. She's got a formula, and if you scream at enough people, mixing with all that, mixed with dancing, of course.
Through the skin and ruptures the collagen and then boosts it. You look like a burn victim for a day, but then it's it, but then it pushes.
What are you pushing into the skin, Sarah?
Sarah?
Carrie? What are you pushing into the skin?
They are both so nervous right now.
Facialist would like to insert into your pores.
But what is it?
It is an extraction from a piece of skin that came from a young person. Far away,
because that matters.
Like, hold on, pause.
Indonesian circumcised.
It's baby dick skin.
So
Indonesian boys' dick skin on their face.
Sandra Bullock used baby dick skin cream.
Here's my thing,
and they injected it into her face.
Where's the baby dick from? She said far away.
Far, far away.
I know,
because that matters.
I've always said that if I had a kid, I would get him circumcised.
Alan totally does it too.
I think I just changed my mind on getting my future kid circumcised. Because
I don't want my son's dick
turned
into face
cream. I don't
want my son's
foreskin on my on Sandra Bullock's face.
On some rich fucking bitch's face.
Was my foreskin on Sandra Bullock's fucking
face,
dude?
Was my foreskin on Ellen's face, dude?
Dude, no!
Dude!
I don't want my dick anywhere near Ellen, dude. And she hates dicks, and she's putting it on her face?
Would you call
also, why don't... Why are the parents getting money from the dicks?
Yeah.
The dick skin.
Why can't I sell my kid's foreskin? Yeah. Or keep it to rub on my face to make myself young and pretty?
Why can't I get his dick skin injected into my face?
Hold on. What about like a Disney movie where it's like an evil witch and she's just trying to abduct children just for their foreskin?
Yeah.
She's just circumcising kids. Because there's tons of witch capturing children things. That's like their main thing usually. Mm-hmm. And how about Sandra Bullock? How about a new...
New witch movie.
All right, we're going to Hollywood, boys. We're pitching a movie where Sandra Bullock is an evil old witch that goes around capturing children from their homes at night.
In circumstances.
And orphanages, mostly orphanages, because they don't care about the orphans. Mm-hmm. And she just, circumcises them. And then, like, maybe... who's going to be the hero here? Danny DeVito ends up killing her. Because
Danny DeVito's the head, like,
the
headmaster
of the orphanage. Yes, the orphanage.
And he keeps getting reports of the kids
getting missing.
Getting made fun of because they're circumcised.
Yeah,
because
she drops them off after. Like some of them, because some of them go to that island, you know? But after they're circumcised, you know? Because she keeps getting younger, so they can't identify her. You know?
Yeah.
Because she's walking around as an infant almost.
Pretty much.
But at the end of the day, you get a fucking tolerance for it, so it wears off quicker. She's got to keep abducting
these
kids.
Then Danny DeVito pretends to be a kid.
Yes. Danny DeVito dresses up in a little schoolboy outfit.
He's already circumcised.
Yeah. No. He's uncircumcised. But they don't know that.
They don't know that.
Oh no, he was circumcised, but he taped like a fucking apparatus to make it look like he had foreskin.
Yeah.
So Sandra Bullock comes at night. He's like, look at this little schoolboy. He's like, I miss my parents. Like pretending that he's an orphan.
I'm an orphan.
I'm an orphan, and all I have left is this beautiful foreskin.
That's all I have.
And she's like, here, my pretty. And she.
Then he pulls out a fucking gun.
Yeah. And he fucking glocks that bitch real quick.
Shoots her in the fucking knee, bro.
She's
crying.
And the movie ends with just her dying, him bawling out.
Crip walking
while some fucking BLP kosher plays.
Ooh.
And then, yeah, we're in the credits just flexing, you know, it's... We'll be side
we
characters
be stunting,
for sure.
Suddenly we got, like, chains.
We'll be some
and,
of the
like,
boys
watches.
that get captured, you know? Yep. We'll be some of the other dudes, the ones that aren't from orphanages, the cool guys that are, like, smoking weed with their foreskins out.
With their foreskins all dirty and winning.
A couple guys in the sauna all foreskinned out, you know?
Yep.
Well, yeah, that's what we'll be. We'll be the one scene in the sauna.
The kid's about to graduate the orphanage.
Basically, we'll be the one comic relief scene where it's like us in the, it's like she like goes to the gym, she's like, oh, there must be some foreskins here or whatever, and it's like us about to like have three-way gay sex in the sauna.
Yeah.
And then she sees our glorious foreskins and we get got.
Yeah.
And everyone, you know, that's the comic punch. Crying. You know?
Because that's all we had.
It's all like, to the Lord. Oh, no, that made our foreskins made gay sex way better because we feel more. And we just keep busting because we can't, you know, we're not getting pregnant.
Damn boom. It.
Yeah, back to Sandra Bullock abducting children for their penis skin.
Fucking bitch.
Dude, right? We need to write this up. Someone on the internet, please write a whole thing for us.
Please and thank you.
Thank you. You know, Hollywood, I know you're listening.
Mm-hmm.
I know you've been testing the waters with us a little bit, seeing if we got what it got. And you heard that.
I know you're listening.
You're probably going to rip us off and not just make it without us. But it'd be cool I got video proof and we'll sue as soon as that happens, dude.
Damn right.
Don't fucking test
us. Don't fucking fuck with
dude.
We fuck.
Know guys.
We know guys.
Mm-hmm. Bitch.
We know guys.
You fucking...
Because we're the motherfucking
ones. Yeah, we're
fucking
the fucking...
Ones who
we're the
call
fucking...
The shots.
We're the fucking motherfuckers, dude.
We're the motherfucking motherfuckers.
Wait, what's the name of the movie going to be? Like,
Wrath...
Foreskin Witch?
Wrath of the...
Wrath of the Foreskin Witch?
Wrath of
the Foreskin. Wait, no. What about just Uncut?
Uncut.
Ooh. Uncut.
People might get confused with Uncut Gems.
Yeah.
Yeah, but...
Uncut.
It's gonna be
uncut.
A movie. It's
Ooh,
not a TV series,
it.
And we'll make sure it doesn't come out on HBO. We'll make brand deals with like a
uncut,
Paramount situation.
Uncut
you know,
men's.
I like Paramount.
Uncut men's.
Uncut
but
men's.
They're boys.
Ooh, what about Uncut Men's?
Yeah.
They're just playing men. Candlebox men, at men, sad as fuck men. Doing a fake funeral for your boy's foreskin, because his girl thought it was gross and made him get cut. And then she left him a week later anyways. That's
same.
How Uncut Men's would go.
It was probably the same bitch that was dating the dude that wouldn't let him hang up the camel sign in his house.
Dude, yeah. For real. Did we talk about that on the pod, or was it that before?
No, that was right before. Should we hit him up?
Dude, there's a guy. We looked up the camel sign that we got, and there's a guy that was selling his...
Bitch
that,
girl.
That, because his fucking stupid bitch wife
stupid,
won't let him
bitch.
Hang the cool-ass camel cigarette sign up.
I hate her. I don't even know her, and I hate her.
Dude, she's a bitch. She probably hung up her dumb shit, too.
Her live, laugh,
probably
love
like
signs.
A fucking signed picture frame of, like, NSYNC that
be
he
happy.
Fucking hates. And he can't have his fucking camel sign? You bitch!
He loves
he
that
He should have
sign.
His own fucking room for all his
He's
signs.
He's had that sign for
You didn't give the guy
years.
A man cave? You probably have an office and a baby room. You fucking turn your office into a baby room and give the guy a fucking man cave, you bitch. Dude, I'm fighting for men's rights, dude, to have fucking cool shit in the house, dude. Like, dude, what the fuck? I could never, dude. If a bitch ever told me to take down my Stone Cold Steve Austin...
Stone Cold?
Stone Cold board, where it's Stone Cold body slamming a pot leaf super high, I would say, how about you hit the road, Jack?
How about you fucking pack your shit?
You know what? You know what, Jack?
Don't you come back no more, no more.
No more, no more, no more. I'm going to be chilling here with Storm Cold.
Yeah.
I don't need you.
I'm willing to hit up Kevin.
Yeah, dude. If a bitch ever made me take down my super cool pictures that I found at the thrift store of those super cool galaxy paintings that were like airbrush and shit.
Or imagine a bitch told you to take down your fucking... Gay sex guys hanging on the walls. Your leather daddies.
Mm-hmm.
Dude.
Imagine she told you, take your leather daddies down. That's stupid.
That's fucking bitch.
That's gay. Take that down.
You're gay. How about that? Leather daddies are cool.
Look at the fit.
Look at them. They're in
Dude,
Nazi outfits. You think I'm taking this down?
I saw some leather daddies.
That's Hugo Boss, you know?
Market. There's like some Harley David leather daddy shit.
Dude, that fucking rules, man. We need to get a mannequin in this bitch. That would be that would complete the
That'd
whole
be
thing.
Nice.
Just a mannequin all leather daddied out. We need a fucking whole house just for studios. And then just have cool gay stuff all over the place.
Apartment building.
Cool fucking vintage gay guy stuff all over the place, bro.
I got a tinkle.
Hell yeah. That's what, I mean, if I can't have my man cave, and by man cave I mean literally a room full of Tom of Finland pictures, what is the point of a relationship?
Yeah, no shit. At that point,
I'd rather be single. Like, it's like, honestly, at that point, too, if you got a problem with it, you're homophobic. Yeah. Like, that's a revolutionary gay artist, dude. He put on for his fucking people, dude. That man spent all day. He fucking drew Camel cigarette ads during the day, and then when he got off the clock, he's drawing dick and balls, man.
It's not my fault that you think I'm gay because I like gay art.
Yeah, dude. First of all, art is gay.
Yeah.
So, fuck you.
Number one, yep.
And fucking, that's the purest form of it. Like, dude, you don't even understand, like, the messages behind that. Because he's sending, like, he's basically saying, yeah, art's gay. But look at how gay this is.
Mm. You want to see something gay? You think this is gay? You want to see something gayer?
This.
This.
This is it. And it rules, man.
Yeah. Look at him.
That's the purest form of art, dude. I wish I could draw fucking guys' abs like that, dude. You think, I can't draw anatomy for shit. Mm. That man knew. And, like, for the time, dude, no one was that ripped. He had a dream of the future. Like, Jesus Christ, man.
Think about the boys that were coming.
And think about it, dude. He's stopping, like, halfway through to jerk off. Like, he's jerking off while he's drawing, dude.
Do you think if Tom of Finland wasn't around, those type of men wouldn't have been around?
Hell no, bro. That gave dudes, like, a body to aspire to. Mm. Like, you know Arnold Schwarzenegger. He had fucking... Tom of Finland drawings all around in his workout room in the basement, because, like, that's what he's aspiring for.
Mm.
And it might have been solo pictures. It may not have been, you know, there might have been a little homophobia there. He didn't have the ones of guys fucking guys. Could have just been a guy flexing with his dick out. You know, he has solo art.
No, 100%.
Yeah. Just people point it out in my studio sometimes. They'll be like, what's up with the gay porn on the wall? I'm like, what are you talking about gay porn? What do you mean gay porn? You mean that art?
Yeah, Tom of Finland art?
You mean that art?
Mm-hmm. They don't know.
It's sending a beautiful message, man. That's talking about society at the time right there, dude. Mm. It's a leather daddy cop, white leather daddy cop with two black punkers sucking on his nipples. What does that say about society?
We live in a society.
Dude, the Matrix is going to come to get us. They're listening, dude.
We'll be prepared.
Once they're done with Andrew Tate, I'm scared.
You're scared?
I'm scared, for sure.
Have we been going for 2 hours?
Yeah, maybe. What time is it?
Jimmy, check how long we've been going for.
We've been for a good bit. Hour 41.
Holy shit. Beep beep boop 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 beep beep. Beep beep boop 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 beep beep.
Yeah, dude.
Let's make it a long one.
Yeah, I love you, Hefner. Right, Jimmy?
Yeah,
you, Hefner.
What?
Some guy at the casino last night.
Oh, yeah, dude. Yeah, how did you hit? Tell him how the casino went.
Yeah.
Hey, you busted out.
How'd you do last night, man?
Busted out.
I can't believe you guys are trying to make me go to that trap, man. Where do you go? Did you go to Twin?
Of course I did.
That was alright. That's an alright move. I just, yeah.
Sometimes you win, sometimes you don't. I lost.
You made $15?
Mm-hmm.
Dude.
I turned a quick $30 into $50 walking out of the door. But I'm still down. But I just made slightly more money.
Slightly less down than...
Yes.
Than four down.
Yes, $20 less down. To be exact.
You go full downs, dude.
I hit 40 on the Playboy machine, first spin.
Yeah,
dude, you should have stuck to the Playboy machine. I don't know what you're doing.
I was like, I saw it. I said, Jimmy, I gotta do it for the BBC.
And then fucking look what happens, dude. Our fucking symbol goes out. It's like, imagine Gotham's being terrorized and Gordon's up there. Gordon's up there trying to fucking turn bat signal on.
We got this sign.
And it's not turning on. Like, what happens then? That's me. Me trying to fucking put the Playboy sign on. I'm Gordon trying to put the Playboy on for the BBC, which is Batman. And the city is being terrorized by our viewers having to see this garbage sign not on, dude.
Yeah, that's a lot.
I'm fucked up a little bit by it, dude. I feel disrespected by it. I feel disrespected by Amazon, by Jeff Bezos.
Dude, I got luckier today at the flea market, though. I looked it up. This watch is worth like $3,000.
That's nice.
How much did you pay?
$180.
I bet it fake.
No, I was looking at
it. I bet it fake. I was looking at it
with my loop. It's all about like.
I bet that shit fake.
Authentic shit inside it.
I bet they gone played, yo.
Imagine they did. I don't care. I'm they done
played, yo. So you're like getting into the watch camp, it seems like.
Hell yeah, dude. Yeah. And I can't believe you didn't get me Travis Scott fakes so I could go down to the store and trade them. Get mad when I get caught on video trying to sell them fakes. Yeah. Fuck you, bro. What do you mean the shit fake? It literally doesn't have the Nike symbol on it.
Nah, fuck you, bro.
Man, fuck you, you bitch ass.
It's like not even the right color.
I'll take this shit elsewhere.
Yeah.
It's like a baby blue instead of the dark blue.
Yeah. What do you mean? Smell that
even
shit,
if
man.
If it's fake, it's still a solid watch. I don't smell know. It looks fucking... Everything seems to be, like, good with it. Maybe the guy was just retarded.
Maybe.
How'd you smell?
No, but he's looking like Buddy.
Buddy.
You think that guy sold you a real watch?
Yeah, that's true.
He not said, really Buddy?
Yeah, it's a good bad. Try.
Did the man like, say Buddy, Buddy like to you or not,
he was
dude?
Like an Italian dude, so I don't know.
I don't know, maybe. He call you a good kid? Do you have, like, a talk before it, so maybe you might have lowered the price?
No, but we were talking about watches for, like, a minute.
You ever get called a good kid by an Italian? It feels really nice. I told you about the dude that I met at the liquor store that, like, was, like, Whitey Bulger's
yeah.
nephew, right?
Well, I was talking about
and
the
and he was
watch,
like, man. I'll beat someone to death for you. Like, that feels real good.
I was talking about the watch, and he's like, oh, you know, but... You know.
You're saying he's Italian, but you're doing
I don't
know, an
do an Italian
accent.
Voice. How do you do an Italian voice?
Like, hey, it's a me! It's a me, Mario. You're a good kid.
You're my divine.
I give you the watch for $180.
$180.
Oh. Or it's like, Christopher.
Christopher,
Christopher, I give you a fucking watch for $150. You don't even fucking give it back.
Get off the fucking edge, Christopher.
Fuck a moron. You mean you don't know how to do an Italian accent? You watch the entire Sopranos. Get over yourself.
Hey, my thing is, though, if it's a fake watch, it is, like...
You've never watched
what? Such a good
hold
fake
on.
That...
Wait, what about Indian Sopranos?
Hey, Christopher!
Now you're doing Italian! Buddy.
Buddy, Christopher, buddy.
He's just in the therapy, and he's like,
I
had a dream that you stuck your boobs in my mouth, and it was very, very nice. You're just so pretty, pretty girl. My mother would have loved if we got together. You beautiful, beautiful, sexy.
Sexy
mama. Ooh.
Sexy middle-aged woman.
You just can't, every time, and, he comes, and then she's like, she turns him down, and he's like, you bitch, I'll never come back, and he comes back the next week, like, you sexy mama, you ready for more? Yeah, just the Sopranos, but it's an Indian guy
yes.
sexually assaulting his therapist every single week.
Hey, mommy.
Hey, mommy. You show me boobs, and I'll tell you what's wrong, come on. I'll tell you what's bothering me if you just show me a little side boob. Dude, that would be
that
sick.
Rules.
I would watch that all the time.
Every day.
It's fucking sick. What is it like? Sanjay Pranos?
Sanjay Pranos.
What's a good... But it's like... It just is a Sopranos, but it's an Arab font.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yes.
I don't know enough about Indian culture to fucking do it. I guess he just owns a liquor store and
smoke shop
instead of like the Bada Bing.
Yep.
And he's always chilling at his buddy's fucking shawarma. I don't know. Some fucking Indian place.
Maybe some like hookah shop.
Yeah.
Or something. I don't know. Do they do hookah?
I don't know. Or maybe he just owns a strip club just like Tony Soprano, but he's like, he just doesn't do really any crime because he's always just like, there like a fucking cartoon wolf with his like tongue rolled out onto the fucking right in front of the stripper, like just fucking smoke coming out of ears and like fucking just like swing, you know, his fucking dick just doing the cartoon head. Stuff. He's hitting himself in the head with a mallet.
Yeah,
like most Indian dudes do when they see a woman. Yeah, and the strippers aren't like that hot. It doesn't matter.
They're kind of
whatever. They like got cankles. They're not even that fat, but they got cankles for some reason. It's weird.
Weird.
It's a weird place.
Out of place.
It's like called the Buddy Bing. I don't know.
Buddy Bing.
What about Bing, the Buddy, buddy Bing?
Buddy know? Bing. Buddy Boom.
Hey, buddy, welcome to the super hot sexy mama strip club. Are you ready to see some food nude? He's got no class. It's like, it's not like Tony where it's just topless. Yeah. It's just full nude.
Yep.
Show me your asshole. Bad. It's unshaved full nude.
It's raw.
Business is terrible, Polly. Everybody comes in and then they walk right out because we're in the middle of South Jersey. People don't like the bush.
They don't appreciate it in South Jersey.
What is it about? Is that like a full-blown stereotype or...
Well...
Indian guys just being really horny? Because I feel like it kind of reigns true across the internet, at least.
It's just those DMs that people find.
It's like crazy, dude.
It's just it's because they don't speak English as their second language, and they're hitting on some girl.
Dude, I'd love to be a chick just for that. Just the DMs from Indian guys.
Yes.
Or I mean, I guess it'd be cool if gay Indian guys would hit me up. That'd be cool. Please show me your penis. Come on, please show me penis. And it's like spelt like... Like fucking P-E-E-N-S.
Yeah.
Show me your peens.
Show me your peens. Please.
Please show me peens.
Show me peens and butt, but it's spelled B-U-T.
Peens and butthole. It's like B-U-T-H.
No,
B-U-T-W-H-O-L-L.
Yes.
Please show butthole.
Butthole on Skype. Please.
Please butthole Skype me now. Dude, I love the idea of just being a guy that has broken English and is incredibly horny all the time.
Mm-hmm. Baby.
of any race, honestly. Like, even just like white foreigner, like a horny Greek guy that's like, I don't even know how to do a Greek, but it'd just be like, mama shum pussy, like, just, no riz.
Mau pasa.
I guess it's like, you just gotta,
pussy now.
You just gotta hit up bitches that speak that language so you can riz in that language, right? If you speak in broken English, there's no way you're trying to riz a bitch.
Wait, but I have a question. Imagine if, like, we go over to, like, to like a different country and then you like try to like speak a different language and like you're doing the same thing that they would do there but with their language.
I feel like at that point they're just like, ooh, an exotic white that doesn't know our language.
Yeah.
We should fuck him. That's how that goes, man. You find the right bitch that just they don't try it. They don't even try it. There's not even an Indian guy just going up speaking what does Indian sound like?
Well, a lot of them speak English because India was a colony of the UK for like 100 and something.
What's
years.
Up with the accent?
I mean, they also speak Hindi.
Oh, yeah. Hindi's, why don't they try to riz a bitch with some Hindi, dude?
The most popular native language.
Let's try rizzing with the Hindi, dude. I think it might work.
But India was a colony for 100.
Because like Spanish guys do it here
go
all the time.
Up to a chick, say the whole Chief Keef, Love Sosa beginning. And like their language, and she would have her pants off in like 5 minutes.
Hey, Mamacita, they've been talking shit on Chief Keef at the barbershop.
They always say this, but he ain't this, but he ain't that.
But he ain't this, but he ain't that. These mamas, though.
Oh, how did my clothes get off?
Indian Chief Keef would be cool, man.
But he's at the barbershop. What are we talking about?
Chief Keef right there. What would his name be? I guess it's Chief Keef. Or like, imagine like Love Sosa, but they have like the Z-tar in the back, and like they're like, oh, la 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 la.
Yeah.
These bitches la, la, la. Love Sosa.
They're doing the dance with the hand turn thing. You know the dance they do with the.
No male wato. Yeah, dude, that rules. Sick.
Sitar hero.
We've already watched Sitar Hero on this.
This isn't This is just a sitar.
And this is a guy playing a sitar?
This is just a guy.
How are you supposed to say it?
Do Love Sosa sitar cover.
Yeah, is that a thing? Yeah. We get that?
Or I Hate Being Sober sitar cover.
I hate being sober. I don't be a smoker. Catch me a drink, I drink muddy water.
That's like a guitar.
Can we get like a Chinese dude doing karaoke of Love Sosa?
I can't see any.
These bitches been talking shit on Keef Keef at the barbershop. They say you can't get that, 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 that.
I don't know what this is.
It's just some trap kid. This is some trapper on TikTok, man. What's
up
with that?
There's no sitar. There's only a guitar.
These bitches be talking shit on Chief Keef on Insta. Bitch, shut the fuck up. Come on, can AI... There's gotta be an AI Love Sosa by Jackie Chan. You heard Jackie Chan's music?
Mm. Pretty fire.
Shit's heat, dude.
Trump.
Right. Fuckers in school.
I mean, that's a class.
Yeah, turn the shit up.
Chief Keef ain't about this. Chief ain't about that. My boy, a BB on fucking Lamron and them. They say that nigga don't be putting in no work. Shut the fuck up. Y'all niggas ain't no shit. All y'all motherfuckers talking about Chief Keef ain't no hitter. Chief Keef ain't this. Chief Keef a fake. Shut the fuck up. Y'all don't live with that nigga. Y'all know that nigga got caught with a ratchet shooting at the police and shit. Nigga been on probation since fucking I don't know when.
I don't know when.
Motherfucker, stop fucking playing them like that.
Stop playing
them. Nigga savages out there. If I catch another motherfucker talking sweet about Chief Keef, I'm fucking beating they ass. I'm not fucking playing no more.
These bitches love Trump. This bitch is love him. I love that one, dude. We get Elvis, Chief Keef. Okay. We could honestly play out the episode with this. I'd be fine with that.
This bitch is love Elvis.
This bitch is love Elvis. Playing the sitar over there, man.
It's, I don't think that's a thing, bro.
I've seen the video. Look up these bitches love Elvis. Or like Elvis Chief Keef AI. But I believe in you, dude. You can find these bitches love Elvis. No. This. These bitches love him. I don't know, dude. I was hoping there'd be a full version of it. You ever seen the guy where he's like, some of your favorite songs were actually originally Elvis songs? Yeah.
Where is it?
Damn, dude, this sucks. That's it. Fucking rules.
Stay gay, America.
Elvis rules, stay gay.